I grew up in a real small town in South Carolina, less than 2,000 people. I remember riding in the car on trips to, you know, to go into grandparents and things like that, and we were always listening to the radio. And my dad would listen to games, and he would listen to the longtime guy. There was a guy named Bob Fulton who was fabulous, and he would listen to Bob Fulton. And so I guess that's how I got hooked. When I was 7 or 8 or 9, I mean, there I was in my room with the 13-inch black and white television, sound turned down, calling the play-by-play of the game, you know, describing the action, listening to other play-by-play guys as they did it, picking up little things from them. But I knew early on that's what I wanted to do. When I got here, Gary Patterson was the defensive coordinator, and I can remember plain as day when Dennis Franchione left, a conversation that he and I had in my office, you know, about him wanting the job, and, you know, and there were others on the staff that wanted it. And then he got the job. It was a real time of renaissance at TCU.
Dalton to a knee one final time. His 42nd win as a starting quarterback, the sweetest of all. A coming out party for Tank Carter as Gary Patterson tries to avoid the Gatorade bucket to no avail. His Horned Frogs have come to Pasadena and proven that TCU and the Horned Frogs are in fact princes of the BCS.
If you said, hey, what do? I would say it's my job to be your eyes during a game. So if you're listening to our game on the radio, it is my job to paint the picture in your mind's eye of what you're seeing.
Five wides for TCU, fourth and goal to the four, comes out of this play. Trevon Boykin, out of the shotgun, takes the snap. Rolling, looks right, throws it too high. Oh, it was caught on the back end! Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? He hauled it in! Dotson tipped it in the air! Aaron Green hauled it in!
Sunday nights, Monday nights, Tuesday nights are usually times for me to spend some time working on what I call my spotting chart, you know, for the game, which is all the information about the players, everything I need to know about the two teams condensed into one sheet. It looks like you would see an NFL play caller have or something like that. And then Wednesday night, I usually try to spend editing audio because we use a lot of audio during the broadcast, so I'll spend time Wednesday on that. Thursday night's a coach's show, and by then I want to be done. The way that I think the city has embraced TCU from when I got here in 98 to today, it's just amazing. In Fort Worth, TCU is the home team. When you're a young guy in this business and thinking, I want to keep moving up to the pinnacle, you know, your goal is to call Rose Bowls. Your goal is to call Fiesta Bowls. Your goal is to be in the college football playoff. To be able to do that, it's pretty amazing, especially here at TCU, I think, you know. And it's taken a lot of time and effort from a lot of different people. And all those people put in all that time and effort, and I get the benefit of being there on game day to describe it. But where we've come from, where we started, it's pretty amazing.
Across the formation will come Boyce, ball to the near hash, 6 yard line, first and goal. Boykin Gibbs, no, he fakes the tuck, taking it outside, inside the three, down to the two, touchdown, hit the horn.